All right, how's it going, y'all? My name's Kris Manning. I'm from Smokey Joe's Barbecue. Today, we got my favorite item outside of ribs is chicken wings. Feel like chicken wings with a Super Bowl party coming up or anything that you got planned, kid's birthday, everybody loves chicken, right? So we're gonna do chicken wings with our all-purpose rub, and we're also gonna use our great bourbon from our partners at Breckenridge Bourbon. We're gonna put some nice glaze on it to give you that sweet and savory flavor, which you know that's like my go-to, to put on our wings. So I'm really pumped about today and kind of just show you guys this recipe so you can use it at home. You can be a great cook for everybody. So before we get started with this all-purpose rub, what I love to use that's a little bit different from everybody is I like to, instead of putting a brine on there, I like to baste my chicken with a little bit of just regular vegetable oil. I feel like it really just brings out the chicken just a little bit differently. That's my way of putting more juices in, making sure that I don't have my chicken dry. So it's a Southern trick that I learned from my dad, and I've been using it ever since. Even at the store, we like to use it. So let's get it going. And like I said, it's just basic vegetable oil. And we're going to go ahead and get this vegetable oil going. And I like to start them down. Like I said, the bottom part of it is, I want the top part to be pretty. So I always like to start them bottom side down. So we're just gonna put a little bit of oil on these. Nothing too crazy. And it's almost in a sense like a binder. It's just an old trick that, you know, my dad always taught me, and I like to use it, bring out a little bit of flavor, so. All right, so let's get these oiled down. Nothing too crazy, just a little dab-a-doo, that's about it, so. All right, so we got these going. So now, we got our oil on before. Once I put my oil on, I like to go ahead and get them seasoned. We're gonna knock these out with that all-purpose rub. Don't be shy with it. We're gonna get this all-purpose rub, kind of lather it all on them. Oh no, it's not enough. Gotta switch to the other side. All right, so we're gonna get these all seasoned on up. And hey, don't be shy with it. That's, you know, that's what my grandma always said. Don't be shy with it, so. All right, so once we get these seasoned, I like to let these sit for about 30 minutes. We'll get them seated. I like to let all those seasons kind of soak into the meat. All right, they look great. So once we get these seasoned, we're gonna let these sit for about 30 minutes. In the meantime, let's get this grill hot. Let's get it to the temperature, not too hot. And when I say hot, not too hot. So we're gonna get this grill to about 250. That's kind of my goal. We've had it going prior to this, so we wanna get it going to about 250 as a desired temp. We're gonna cook them all slow, and at the end, we're gonna flash fry them, sear them a little bit, get that little crisp on them, get that little char on the chicken, and not only get the smoke flavor, but get the grill flavor too. And that's the dynamic duo of the Nomad. So, the Nomad's been going for about, I would say about 30 minutes now. So we got the Nomad going. I think we're ready to load. I'm excited. I'm really excited for these. These are one of my favorite items to cook. And I feel like everybody loves chicken, whether it's kids, whether it's their dads, moms, everybody. So this is one of my favorite items to cook. So let's go ahead and get them loaded. And, all right, y'all. Y'all hear that? She sounds good. She sounds really good. All right. And so my temp on my Nomad is feeling really good. And to slow it down and get that smoke flavor, I like to go ahead and close it off. So we got these loaded. Let's go ahead and get them sealed. All right. So while we're cooking on this Nomad, my goal is, let's go ahead and this one closed and close this one. And we're gonna close this one on this side too, on the back side. And we're gonna let it slow smoke. I feel like if we have the desired temp, which we do, we got a desired temp, this Nomad is like the Yeti of grills in my opinion. And so we wanna just cook really smooth. It's very sealed. The mechanics on this thing is just amazing. It's gonna hold the temperature that we wanna desire. So we can also utilize it as a smoker as well as a grill. So while we have this thing smoking really slow and going, We're gonna let it take our time. I would give this about an hour, hour and 15 minutes. All right, so we've been going for about an hour and 20 minutes now. I'm gonna look at these wings. I wanna tip them a little bit. Let's see where we're at. Keep in mind, we're gonna flash sear them a little bit at the end. So we're looking for about 150, not 150, I'm gonna say about 162, 163. So let's get this Nomad open. Let's see how we look. I'm excited. Oh, wow. Okay, so we are looking great. Color looks, but let's check the temp, obviously. Let's make sure our temperature is good. We're looking great, 163, all right. We look good. I'm really happy with these. The color looks great. They are looking great. Okay, so let's go ahead and get these wings pulled off. We're gonna get them pulled off. And first, we're gonna pull them off. And so I like to gather color. The color on these looks really great. I'm really happy with these. But, you know, with this Nomad, we gotta get the best of both worlds. That's the whole point of we're cooking on a Nomad, right? So when we're grasping the best of both worlds, we got a nice smoky flavor on the Nomad, but now we wanna get that sear to get that char on there. I like, you know, a combination of both really brings out the flavor in the wing, in my opinion. So now that we got these off, let's go ahead and we're gonna boost this temp on this Nomad. So we got some wood chips over here. We're gonna get this Nomad nice and hot. Get it up the temp. All right. She's getting there. If I can't leave my hand right there, that tells me she's hot. All right. So I like the way she's looking. I'm gonna give her about a minute or so. I just wanna bring up just a little bit temp, get a little bit faster. I think that was the magic touch. All right. Let's go ahead and get the simmer. Let's go ahead. Okay. You hear that? That's the sound I want to hear. That is what I like to hear. So when we're searing these wings, we just want to sear them for maybe 30 seconds to a minute. It's not going to take long. Keep in mind, they're already at 163, 164 internal temp. So we're looking to get them to 165. Don't want to burn them. We just want to get a little bit of char on them to kind of get the best of both worlds of smoking the chicken, but also grilling it. I feel like, you know, you got to utilize that when we're cooking on a Nomad. It's a very imperative, it's very important. So now that we got these on, they're looking good. And we got a little bit of that mesquite flavor profile from our wood chips that we just put in there. I'm happy with it. All right. They're looking great. I'm looking for that bubbling in there. That's what I'm looking for, to kind of just get a little char on them. Yes, that's exactly what I'm looking for. Kind of add that char, that little crunchiness a little bit to them. Yes, that's what I'm looking for. So we're gonna jump right into the glaze. So as we're jumping into the glaze, I'm gonna heat up my cast iron. Hey, it's like grandma said, everything's better than cast iron. So I'm gonna heat up my cast iron. And what I like to use in my glaze, I like to use just the basic, your Texas honey that you can get in Texas pretty much anywhere, simple honey. And I like to always use just a K-roll syrup. And I like to use with our partners, Breckenridge bourbon. It brings a great flavor profile that just really brings out a different dynamic. And so that's what I like to use in my recipe of my glaze when we're making these nice chicken wings to give them that nice sweet but savory flavor as well. All right, so now we got our cast iron hot. We're gonna put this over here. And let's get it going, guys. I'm excited for this. All right, so we got that going. Add our cinnamon to that. Add our honey. It is looking good. We gotta get all that honey. Yes, it is looking good. All right, so we got that. Add that K-roll syrup. All right, gonna set that down. And last but not least, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna add the best ingredients. bourbon, the fun stuff. All right, so, and I just like to add just the 8-ounce cup. Just be careful, you know, it is bourbon. We are cooking the glaze out, so keep that in mind. You don't want too much. You want just the adequate amount to cook it out, so. And first things first, as soon as I put it on, I want to go ahead and stir it. And that way that brown sugar doesn't burn and stick at the bottom. And this is just looking wonderful, you guys. And we want this to all commence together, all come together and just really start gelling, get all sticky, and that's what we're looking for. And our goal, ideally, is it's gonna catch on fire, so you wanna be careful and keep that in mind. But, however, with that being said, it's gotta cook the alcohol out, so that's a very important aspect to this, so. And when we're cooking this, we wanna make sure this is some item that we're gonna stand over, we're gonna pay attention to. We're gonna make sure that, hey, we wanna make sure that we're stirring it, one, so it can be stirred in properly, two, because this is gonna catch on fire, so we wanna keep that in mind as well. And I love cooking on a cast iron Nomad. It's just something like they go hand in hand in a sense, so. All right, this is what I'm looking for. Looks good. And we'll cook it just a little bit more. I'm looking at it. I just wanna see how it is. And I'm looking at basically at the back of that spoon, how it's dripping off slowly. I want it to drip off just a little bit slower. So let's get it going just a little bit hotter. Let's bring it up to temperature. I like where she's going though. I feel like this is she's almost there. It's just a little bit more time. We're gonna get her just finishing on off and then we're gonna be ready to put them on the wings. All right. So she's glazing on up right now, and if you just look at that, that is just lovely. I mean, I am just really happy with that. It looks good. So now here comes the fun part. We are going to put it on the chicken. Gonna get that nice glaze on there. And we're gonna mix it all in there. And what I'm gonna do is, this little hack, I wanna cook that glaze into the chicken. So I'll turn these, all my chicken wings upside down per se, and we're gonna add a little bit more glaze, and we're gonna put them back on the Nomad and let them go for maybe 10, 20 minutes. And we're gonna get all that on there and let them just soak in the glaze. And that's my goal with this glaze is kind of soak them in there, really cook it in there and just bring that flavor profile out along with the all-purpose rub. All right, so now that we got them in the pan, we're gonna put them back on this Nomad, let them slow smoke a little bit. And I'm excited for this finished product. All right, so we're gonna go on for about 10, well, I'd say about 15 minutes. So let's pull them off. And that's what I like to see. All right, so we're gonna pull these off. Whew, it's a little hot, a little hot. We're gonna pull these off. They've been sitting in the glaze, cooking in the glaze for about 10 to 15 minutes. Now, we gotta do the best part, which is eat. So I'm happy and excited to see. So let's dive in. Now that, and what I love about this wing, hold on. What I love about this wing is, it's not your standard wing of just having just a savory flavor. It has a sweet bourbon flavor profile, and that Breckenridge just, that and that all-purpose rub goes together, it's just like magic, you know? I don't even know a better way to explain it. That's good. Want to surprise your friends? Let me know what you think. Check us out at Smokey Joe's Barbecue. Check out our rub. Give us a follow, give us a shout.